Alright, hello everyone, welcome. So this may be the second live stream, and today we're going to make a product then also, and we'll see how we can export that as OBJ. I have rendered that, so this is the final product that we will make. It's very simple, and you will learn a lot of stuff. So let's get started with a new fresh file. I will enable the screencast case. Every single address you will see here. And I will load the reference image. Here is the reference image. And to be honest, we have the subdimensions. To work on that, we will make a plane. We can make it, call it reference and move to the Z dimension. And we can center that to be here. Maybe also add a plane and scale on the x axis. We may center that to be here. Okay. And after that, I'll select all and press Ctrl Shift B. So you see, this isn't proper scale. So what is happen? You can find that we didn't apply the scale. So you should apply the scale. And when you press Ctrl Shift B for the bevel, you will see that the bevel is consistent on X and Y. So maybe we go to 7, maybe 7, let's see, 7 and something like that. And after that I will join this. We don't need the reference anymore, and I will join all of this. Press join because we want the mesh and the polygons to be clean. We don't need any engines. That will help us later. Let's see. We are joining 3, 3. We can join also ZS. Maybe let's join that in the short dimension. So what happens here? We have here 4, 4, 4. So all are quads, no triangles or angles. What is a triangles? Triangles is a face with 3 edges, and angles is a face with more than maybe 5, 6, and so on. So this is triangles and this is angles. But when we model, we tend for making a perfect square for axis, and that is what we tend to make. Okay, and here we can make something. We can make inset, or we can select all and extrude scale something such as this. And scale on the Y. And select all and scale maybe 0.99, 0.98 maybe. So after that, let's see, that's fine. So after that, we will make an extrusion, maybe to this, maybe 1 millimeter. So this is not the right dimension, but we will fix that later. And we can now extrude that maybe to be here, 0.234, and I will add here another loop cut. Select that and Alt E extrude faces along normals, and another point here, and make it round, such as this. So we have now made the case or the box, and you can now add the subdivision surface. It's clean, so that's fine. For the inner, we can add here a loop cut such as this to make it clean. And I think for now we may slide that to make it round, maybe such as this. So we make it round, that also maybe scaled shift Z 0.9, scale shift Z. Let me see. Let's scale all these faces. Scale shift Z and scale on the Y. That's fine. So we have here round shape. I will assign that we may use later, and of course that will be shade smooth. Alright. And I will select all of these faces and duplicate to make the cover, and I will name that to be the cover, and the cover will be have, let's see, will make another extrusion and scale on Y, and after that we may, let's see, we may make an extrusion and I will add loop cut here, and after that I will select all of these parts and make some height. So we should make some height now in the front. We make an extrusion and move that in the X axis, such as this. We may add loop cut here and other loop cut here. That's fine. And I think we are now done, but I think we may scale that in the y-axis. That's fine. I move in the x-axis. And move here in the x-axis. And for the height, we may decrease that to be here. And I think now we are done. For all materials, I will name it white. It will be white, but roughness maybe 0.2. And clear coat, we want clear coat, and metal maybe 0.2. This also white, but the inner will be chrome. So the inner parts will be chrome. So that will be a chrome and a sign. This will be metal. Roughness maybe 0.15, anisotropic 0.5, and some clear coat, and that will be a sign, and make it light gray maybe, and just a sign. We have now add all materials. There's an dent here, so we can add that by selecting all of that and inset, and add circle to be here, and just make an extrusion to be here and scale. That's it. We are now ready to render. I have set up scene for render at backdrop, camera, and some lights, and I have made a tutorial for that you can find in my channel. That's easy. Let's see what about the camera angle. We can make this camera angle, and for the camera, maybe we have it 90 or 70, and at this angle, and let's see what about the render. It may be fine, but we can add an HDRI, and there is a lot of ways for adding HDRI. One of that is using the Polyhaven. Polyhaven is add-on you can test for free, or you can purchase for $30, and it has a lot of HDRI models, texture, and so on, and you can upload all the content of the website using this button, which is the fetch or search for new assets. And that's it for the tutorial. We have concentrated on how you can make or adjust, or how you can make a new clean model using a few steps. In the next live stream, we'll make also another design from scratch, product design, and that will be long video, not simple or short such as this. I hope you like this tutorial. See you in another live stream on my channel, Camera Time on YouTube.